We're in Auburn, Alabama on a drilled shaft project. The project is deep foundations for a condominium that's going up here in Auburn. We've got temporary shoring going in and then two phases of drilled shaft work. We've got 22 shafts on the first phase and 150 on the latter phase. My name's Dennis Smith. I'm a superintendent for Russo Corporation. The three basic foundation technologies that we use are anchored earth, drilled shafts, and micropiles. In this case, we're using drilled shafts as a deep foundation for the condominiums going up. The way a drilled shaft works is it transfers a load from a structure above to a bearing strata below, kind of like a column in the dirt. The rated capacity for the piers is about 700,000 pounds, or about 54 elephants or 20 Greyhound buses.
So a drilled shaft, or a caisson, is a cylinder ranging from 18-inch to 13-foot in diameter, where we use the auger bit to drill to a certain depth, anywhere from 5, 10, to 120 to 200 feet deep. All the dirt rock material will come out of the hole and produce a round cylinder to fill with a circular rebar cage and fill with concrete all the way from the bottom to the top. This is a Solmec SR45 drill rig. They're made in Italy. Rotary driven drill rig powered by a Kelly bar and a rotary. Upwards of 100,000 foot pounds of torque. To correlate torque, your normal everyday pickup truck, your engine produces around 300 to 400 foot pounds of torque. And this machine produces upwards of 100 to 120,000 foot pounds of torque in the rotary to turn the Kelly bar and drill the shaft as deep as you need it. This is a 48-inch rock auger with carbide teeth.
When we start pouring the shaft, once we drill it down, we got to get the right depth, the right elevation. Then we got to get with the engineers to give me the right concrete elevation, the right steel elevation. So what I start doing, I start pouring without putting the steel in if it's a floating cage. So when I get so much in there that I stop, then I reach back, grab my steel, put it in the hole and let him shoot it. Give me the right elevation. I let the crane hold the steel. I start back pouring concrete. I get enough concrete in there to stabilize the steel. I cut the steel loose. Then I come on up to the right elevation, and that's the hole.
First recorded drilled shafts in North America were put in under the Brooklyn Bridge. And back then, they had to dig them by hand, and it could take up to several months to put one shaft in. Now, with the technology we've got, we're able to do multiple shafts per shift or even as fast as one every 5 or 10 minutes.
I got into this business as a part-time job out of college, and 13 years later, I'm still here. I'm from Monroeville, Alabama. I went to Monroe Academy in high school, ended up here in Auburn, went to college here at Auburn, graduated in 2005. And came from a family of John Deere salesmen. Ended up with Russo as part-time, looking for a full-time job. And 13 years later, I'm still here at Russo.
Typically, you'll find all kind of different objects when you're drilling. Old metal pilings or all kind of different things. Just never know what you're going to find out of the hole.
Yeah, my passion for this industry started when I was working with my uncle on a summer job. Fell in love with it and been here ever since. 41 years. I started back in 77, and I'm still here in 2018. When I started with the company, I did not have any formal education in doing this. I had on-job training, learned by hands-on. If I were looking for someone to be hired on or to make this a career for them in this industry, I would tell them this would be a good thing to do, good pay, good hours, good people to work for. It'd be a good thing all the way around.
I'm headed out right now to go to the Tractor Supply to pick up a few things to keep the job going. But I don't have to worry about everybody standing around wondering what to do. We've got a good enough team on site to keep work going, even if I'm on site or gone.
Well, I got two cousins, my uncle's son, but I came upon them. Then I got a good friend of mine, then I got a bunch of friends. that we came up with. A bunch of guys that I bought in and we learned. I learned them and trained them, and they're good guys, good fellas, good-hearted people.
And the team on site is really like a fraternity of brothers. We're all together with each other really more than we are with our families. We depend on each other for our livelihoods as well as our safety. We work in a typically dangerous industry, and without the brotherhood of having each other's backs, you're more likely to be injured or have an accident.
This here is my cousin Chris Smoke. He's a man of all trades. He do it all. And he'll do what you ask him to do. He just got a mouth sometimes, but he okay with me. I love him. This is Lewis Wright. I met him a long time ago, and he's a good friend of mine. He worked real hard, real hard working. Lewis Wright. This is LaShawn Moe, this is Chris' brother, this is my cousin. He's a good guy. He knows pretty much what to do with labor foreman. He knows how to handle his business. Now this is my boss right here, Clark Gary. Good man. The best supervisor I ever had.
So in this line of work, you never know what you're gonna get into.
Every day's different. No 2 days are the same. You never do the same thing twice.
If you're out on the job site, it never requires a suit unless you really like to show out and look good and get dirty.
I think if a suit was required, I would have to change professions. I couldn't stand to wear a suit every day and be confined with a tie.
Last time I wore a suit was Wednesday night. We're running revival, and I did the revival. And I did the revival on Wednesday night.
Foundation drilling isn't for everyone, but for those who have the self-motivation and determination to succeed, it's a chance of a lifetime.